What's going on, dudes, boys and girls, friends and viewers, people who I do know and those I still do not. My name is Kolosalus, welcome back to another Heroes video. Today, we are finally taking a look at Sonya. She used to be like at the top of the bruisers back, I think, after Artanis came out. That was like a long time ago. She used to be banned and picked every single Healy game, every single competitive game, especially. Just because she packed so much punch, and that also came with a lot of survivability and health. Then she kind of fell off after the nerfs happened to her kind of generic talents that she had, because that was the standard build for her. Generic talents all the way. Now, I think yesterday, a patch release where she received a couple of changes to her E, to her whirlwind, which makes it much, much better to sustain herself. And it actually makes it more attractive to go for the whirlwind upgrading talents. So we're gonna take a look at that kind of theorycraft build today. I was trying it over the last couple of days after the patch hit. Actually, it was just yesterday. Yes, yesterday and today. I was kind of practicing it, kind of theorycrafting it with the viewers on the stream today. So we're just gonna look at what Sonya is right now and what we came up with.
My blades are yours.
Alright, boys and girls, we find ourselves on the Forehead Junction. We do have the event. This used to be almost undoable, unless you had like the best coordination ever. Now it's actually pretty easy to do. Just gonna pick this stuff up and just gonna turn it into this guy. This might be your first time seeing it, so there you go. You have to give him whatever's in this little circle. The next one is going to be the golden bullion. I call it the golden bullion. There you go. And the firecrackers are the last. And there we go. Awesome. This team. I'm feeling block. I'm feeling block. Warpaint seems pretty nice as well. Alright, let's go for warpaint. Warpaint is going to be, will be basically life stealing a little bit of the damage that I deal with my basic attacks. Very, very good for sustaining her. I think it should be her base, but I guess we will see what Blizzard chooses to do with her. Her Q ability is called Ancient Spear. Ancient Spear is going to basically attach to an enemy that has a pretty nice range, and then it pulls you towards the, it's kind of like a different swap from Artanis or a different hook. It's very, very, it's much shorter range. So there you go, I'm going to showcase it off here. I hit that minion and I just kind of attach myself to it and pull myself. Of course, it also deals damage. By the way, if you do not hit anything, you're not going to get pulled. So just don't use it like that, because it's just not going to do anything. It also is also our main fury generator. Our fury is our trait, which I will show you guys soon. Which I will not show you, but I will explain it to you. I am going to be careful now because the enemy team is missing. They do have a Valyria Nova gank squad. It looks like Valyria is in the middle, so I'll be fine to just engage into this. Oh, hey, Baron. You know you can't trade with me, right? Yeah, that's what I thought. RW ability is what I use there to push that Varian out of the lane. It is called Seismic Slam. What it does, I slam onto the ground. I'm able to just get them both, but looks like she just really wants me. I'm slamming the ground, dealing a lot of ability damage, and then also a little bit in the cone behind. I wonder if it doesn't show it. Yeah, I also do a little bit in the cone behind it, kind of, you know, just kind of like, it's very, very minuscule. It's just terrible damage. Like, it's, you would think it's good for like wave clearing, but it's not even good for that. You know what I mean? I saw her somewhere. So you can see that it does 50 damage, which is just nothing. And I'm gonna make my way top now. I cleared this wave, so I'm gonna make my way top to help with this nuke. It looks like our Samurai will be taken out, maybe. Hi, Zillion. Oh, fucking shit. RIP! Rest in pepperonis, this Zul'jin. Once he gets his macro in you, you're just dead. He's really, really... I kind of figured out that he fills the same role as Valyria. Not Valyria, what the fuck? Vala, that's what I meant. Anyway, that's a very bad placement for a nuke. It's not even going to get any of these structures. And not even going to get the well. So we're playing against good players, boys. High level game confirmed. Anyway, our ability is called Whirlwind. Just watch what was buffed. It actually deals more damage now and heals you for more. It basically deals 516 damage, which is pretty nice, over 3 seconds, or like basically it ticks a little bit, like almost any ability. So I'll show it to you here. Let me generate some of the fury, and there you go. I'm just gonna deal that damage, basically getting that tick, I think, twice a second. I think that's how much it is. And yeah, that's basically what it's gonna do. I'm gonna go middle because I'm a good solo laner. Level 4, we are going to pick up... Hurricane is just not gonna get any value here, so I'm probably gonna go Focus Attack. Focus Attack is gonna allow us to deal a little bit more damage with our basic attack to a hero every like 6 seconds or something. It'll be 60 seconds. Ooh, okay, they took this, so I should be careful. Valera is here. Yeah, so those are our ability. Actually, it's not Valera, it's Nova. Hi, Nova. Hi, Nova. Yeah, so... and we have our Fury, which we use it instead of mana, and we generate it by taking damage, I think. Taking or dealing damage. There we go. We're able to punish him a little bit. We have to be careful because she can just stun us out, and for 2 seconds we won't be able to do anything. Alright, so we did take that variant out, so we're gonna just kind of rotate to the bottom now. We'd have to be careful of the Nova rotation because she's gonna be kind of deadly against us if we don't have a lot of things to heal from. So you can see, when we use our E, we do get kind of a little bit burst of healing, which is exactly what we want, right? So again, I use Fury instead of mana, which is gained by taking or dealing damage, using basically our heroic ability, grants 10% movement speed as well. So, again, very, very good. This level, we're going to go for Poison Spear. That was another kind of Fury craft. This was buffed in the patch, so why not take it? It actually deals quite massive damage now, and honestly, it's just really good. I'm going to go middle now, because this Aureole is rotating very, very aggressively. You can see just how much damage it actually does now. I'm gonna be taken out. Looks like nobody followed us. People were just bottom and middle and stuff, and now they actually want to go for the objective. Which is a terrible idea, because we split and we're just gonna be start paying unless we just back off. We have Valera somewhere there. If she picks you up. There you go, there's the Valera. That's what I was expecting. Alright, so as you can already see, Valera is kind of good, because she can stun me out of my whirlwind. It's worth to say that nothing besides stun or silence will actually put me out of my whirlwind, but yeah, it's kind of what the enemy team does right now. I'm gonna try to get this nuke without the enemy team getting me. Hopefully I will, so no, Nova is here. So I'm gonna just need to back off, because Varian, I think I saw him rotating. Looks like... Nope, nope, nope. Nope. Fucking Varian going for the Warbringer as well. I'm gonna try to heal, but one target is just not enough. By the way, it's also worth to mention that I will be healing for triple against heroes rather than 25%, you know, 25% versus normal enemies, so like enemy minions or mercenaries. Against enemy heroes, it's gonna be tripled, so it's gonna be like, what, 75% of the damage dealt, which is pretty good, right? Pretty good if you stand like in between like 3 people. At least. I'm gonna go middle because we do need soaking, we need to get to level 10. I'm still not sure on the heroic choice though. The stun might be good, the mic stun might be good for peel. Ooh, what the fuck are they doing here? Lol. Lol. Oh, that's a Colossus Smash. That is a Colossus Smash. Yeah, they're doing everything that they want to right now. I mean, they are kind of in the four-man, so... no wonder, right? No wonder. I'm gonna take this camp out. Honestly, it's the only thing I can do right now. And I'm going to, again, start soaking. We need to soak the shit out of this right now. I'm not sure. Like, this is another duo that we have, Tassadar and Varian. And they're just soloing. Like, that's what I don't like about Quick Match. Like, people just, they're in a solo scenario. Okay, I think we have enough damage. I'm gonna go for the leap. I'm gonna take it especially for its usability, for its utility that I can use, right? I can use it to peel, I can use it to engage into fights, I can use it for honestly a lot of stuff. I'm not sure why we're afraid of Oreo. Just, I mean, okay, now they're missing, so now I'm gonna just bail because I don't want to get wrecked. Okay, variance here as well. We do need to start looking for pickoffs, like for example these ones. Like, I'm taking damage for no reason. Very nice pick. That was exactly what we were looking for. I'm gonna jump in, stun the enemy team, and they're gonna be taken out, especially the enemy variant. And Nova coming here for some hot sauce. I'm gonna use this, but she's gonna be taken out right after she exits that crystal, and then we will pick up a kill on the enemy Oriole. Now we should be going for the boss. I am going to back off for just a little bit to get some health. If we do get shields from Tassadar, this is not gonna be an issue, but we do need Tassadar. We do need Tassadar, really. Just start hitting it. Just hit it in the face. I'm on my way. Our friendly variants going for the Colossus Smash. I'm not gonna say that I like it necessarily. I think it was a bad choice, but I think it might help us. It might help us with blowing up some targets. We do need to be careful about this though. The enemy team is closing in. That's fine. That precision strike just basically did nothing. It basically did nothing. Okay, we're gonna give up the top one, I think, for to pick this up. Ooh, got him! Yeah! We got him good. Alright, now my leap is up, so now I can actually be a little bit more ballsy, right? I'll be able to maybe secure us a couple of kills, or actually get out of the teamfight. You see how big of range it had. I'm gonna engage on this Nova, then you hit her with a spear, she's gonna give us a nuke! Thank you for that nuke, Nova. You like it? You like that? You like that leap? That was just the leap value. Like, this leap has so much range, and I'm gonna actually use the middle. I'm gonna use the middle to destroy that well, and also give us a head start on that fort. It's gonna be good. I'm telling you guys, it's gonna be good. We're gonna go for life funnel on this level of range. It's gonna give us just a little bit more healing, right? It's gonna give us actually 35%. Of healing rather than 25, which is super good, super super good. We are just getting kills left and right. Are we gonna be able to finish this? I don't think we will be able to finish this though. Fuck you, Nova. Fuck your precision strike. All right, let's back off. We can get a couple of forts here. Dude, Samurai just doesn't know when to back off, right? Let's get this fort. This fort is basically dead. There we go. That fort is down, and our Samurai's dead. Didn't I just tell somebody to back off? I'm gonna go top to get this camp. Alright, so did I explain everything? Poison Spear, again, just Poison Spear, what it does, it makes you basically deal more damage with your spear, but the damage applies, like the additional damage is 150% of the actual spear. And it applies over time, so it's kind of like an Envenom effect, but it's very strong Envenom effect. You guys saw, it basically takes more than I think it takes like a third of health. Let's take this to Jen. He's alone. Okay, I guess not. I guess I'm just wrong. She got wrecked. Did Valeria get wrecked? Yeah, she Valeria just died, which is good. Okay, I'm going a little bit to him now. I'm going a little bit to him. Okay, we don't have anything. Oh my god! Okay, I'm gonna get hit by that closer smash. I can already see my death. I mean, he wants to go in. He can go in. We can easy turn around this. Easily, right now. Okay, I'm gonna go for Nerves of Steel. Nerves of Steel is gonna allow me to gain a little bit of shield. It's very, very similar to... what was the talent called? I don't even remember. It used to be some shield. I don't remember actually what the hell it was called. Come on, engage me. I know you want to. I know you want to engage. He doesn't have his... okay, there we go. There's the engage. And this should result in an easy kill. I'm gonna activate my shields here to gain a little bit of our survivability. Now we're just gonna go back. Let's channel our... Tell our friends that we're gonna go back and let's go for the nuke. This is a safe play. Our variant is here. I don't know what he's doing. I'm gonna need this globe, so I'm gonna stay around. Thank you, babe. That's so selfish. I was just there for the globe. He's just there. What the fuck just happened? What happened? I might get wrecked though, because that was Nova or some, or maybe Valira. And they used a nuke on nothing. The fuck just happened? Okay, I mean, I'm not gonna dwell on it. We're not gonna dwell on it. We're gonna kill this Oreo. I think that's what we're gonna do. We're just gonna kill this Nova because she doesn't know what the fuck is going on. You're not getting away from me. Oh, she is getting away from me. Fuck. Oh, I got the Nova! Our life is complete now. It was terrible. I just did what you never want to do. Our team was wiping when I went into three people and killed Nova and got killed right after that. Valira is right here. She is going to be, I think, taking out my girlfriend. And she's basically not going to get countered at all. She's going to go into Vanish right after. Oh, okay, reveal. She's revealed, and now the stun is going to secure. Okay, we need to grab this nuke and then push. Nuke? There we go. Now he catches it. Alright, so whirlwind again. Gonna give us a little bit more healing with our whirlwind, and then we got some shields. This is also usable while whirlwinding. This used to be called Stone Skin. There we go. Used to be called Stone Skin, but they renamed it and they basically slapped on usable while whirlwind. That's basically what they did. 100%, I'm not even lying to you. That's basically it. They buffed her by giving her more damage and more percentage of the actual damage healed. Oh god, you're overextending, baby squirrel. I don't know what you're doing. What the hell? I mean, I'm fine with using my 60 second cooldown on. Oh, sorry, is it 60 or is it 70 right now? Oh, whoa. That was. I didn't mean to go back in. That was my fault. Well, look at you! I just revealed you, piece of shit. Get me out! Where's our Tazdar? He got wrecked right before me. I don't know. Oh, this kind of positioning from Tazdar was kind of questionable, at least to say. Tazdar is not the same character anymore. I do have to make a video about him. He was just reworked, and he is just not as survivable as he used to be. I'm not doing too well, just because they have such a single damage team. Like, they focus on that one target and they can just delete it with the Valira variant combo. And of course there's a Nova as well, and it's just not fun for me. So I'm gonna try to play a little bit more careful. We have to be careful of the bottom nuke getting captured by Oriole, I think. Actually, Vayne might be able to get there in time. I'm not sure what we're doing there. Oh, actually, he's not gonna be able to he will be able to reveal her with the Blade Storm. This Blade Storm is gonna be a fucking this is just a sausage fest. What the hell was that Blade Storm? He should have waited a little longer. And our Vayne looks like he did not get to Oriole in time, so the enemy team does have two nukes at their disposal. Honestly, that's fine. That's okay. We can still come back. I mean, they're down. Like, we are winning right now. We are winning. The enemy team, we should be careful of the enemy team, might be starting a boss right at this moment. So I'm going to just stand in this bush, see what they do. Of course. I'll say they are kind of down here. I do have my leap at my disposal right now. So if we do decide to everybody gather, we could get a nice engage. The enemy team isn't entirely there. Oh my god, the blow up was cray cray, boys. Where are you guys going? Okay, he's gonna go tell Dingo. Okay, he's dead as fuck. Okay, I do need the shields right now. Oh my god, the AoE damage is crazy. La 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 la, I'm just gonna fucking hit you with my shit. Oh god. We are getting wrecked right now. Wrecked to Rooney, baby, you have to be careful. That one hit would have killed her. God damn, that was close, baby. That was close. Close call. But I don't think it was worth. I'm gonna go for Crater. Fuck it. We're gonna YOLO it. We're gonna YOLO it with the crater. What, by the way, what the crater will do for you, it will reduce the cooldown of our leap by 20 seconds. And also, basically make people trapped with you in kind of like a crater area. We are pushing up with this wave. Not sure what for, but I guess we could do it. I guess we could find out what it brings us, right? I'd have to be careful because the enemy Valira is up and healthy. Looks like she is top right now though, so we're gonna take this camp to get this push going. And honestly, we can try to go for the win here. We can try to go for the win, but is this something we can engage? No, I don't think so. Just back off. Yeah, but just back off. Yep. Just back off. That's the one to do, boss. I think that's a good idea. The enemy team might not be expecting this, but okay. Hello. Hello, that's a crater right there. Where's she? Oh, there she is. There she is. She's gonna get taken out. What the crater will actually do for you, which is very... Oh my god, Samuro. Run away, baby squirrel. What it will actually do for you, it's gonna trap people with this crater, which actually makes you 100% hit your whirlwind, which is exactly what you want, right? Like, you want that to happen. You want as many people as you can in that crater with you. So when you can basically hit somebody 100% of the time, that's actually a lot of value. So our crater is almost already up. That's how crazy it gets. If we get these two nukes, we can definitely finish the game. Then we basically have four nukes on us. This stuff will be fine, and we should just go bottom. We should just go bottom and just finish the game. Whoa, wait, are you okay? Yes, you are okay, but this Nova, she's having a very bad day. She was having... Baby, we have to nuke now. Like, we have to go now. Don't go. You're gonna get shields. You're fine. This Tassadar is like the best Tassadar in the world. You have to imagine that. Just believe. Just believe in our little Tassadar right there. Okay, I am gonna be taking a little bit of damage. We need to nuke this mother... Yeah! 50 nukes coming up right now. Look how much damage he's taking right now. Look how much damage he's taking. I'm gonna go with my shield right here. The enemy Test Dingo is... not enemy Test Dingo, but the enemy troll is doing a lot of damage to us, but this is gonna be game. We did get a triple kill. We just had too much damage. We had too much damage because of... Oh my god, what the fuck are you doing? Where are you going? She is here still somewhere. Oh, I think she escaped. She just escaped in the last second. But okay, my girlfriend died. Tester died. God damn it! But we still won the game. Still won the game. So I'm still spinning. I'm still spinning. I'm so happy. I'm still spinning. Holy shit! I had 5 deaths. I did not expect to make MVP, but there we go. Best damage in game. Best in team. Best siege damage. Best hero damage. And just beasting and feasting it up. All right, you're gonna get it from me, Tester. Coxter, his name is Coxter. Good job, Coxter. If you're watching this, there's like a 0.00001% chance of you watching this, because nobody watches me. Yeah, my baby watches me. Best siege damage, best hero damage, best roll, best like damage taken. I was the best in that. I was best in damage taken, 100%. I mean, I died a lot. And also best XP contribution. XP contribution in quick match shows if you're not a specialist, shows how much you know about the game, how much you know the laning phase is worth. So I really feel like it gives you a lot of understanding about the game. I do believe this build is good. I do believe it's actually very surprising to the enemy how much damage they can get with a poison spear. And the overall burst of your survivability if you pick up one of the talents before. So Warpaint level 1, again, any of these is good for certain situations where I think the best one, if you have a very reliable support, is going to be Shadow Fury, where you can activate your D to get a little bit of Fury for free. Then you can start whirlwinding without actually having Fury, without having to generate it, which is good, right? Which is very, very good. You don't want to sometimes use your Q to engage into a fight. You might just want to walk into it, just start E-ing, and then maybe Q out if you pick up a certain talent, which actually always pulls you. You might say, why don't you always pick it? Well, because it's not the best. I'll explain in a second. But Warpaint was our choice here. We did have a support, but he was a kind of a support. It was Tastar, so it's kind of a support, but not a healer support. He's a much better solo healer right now. But I know he has 8 second cooldown on his shield, which means we are just not going to get healing from him every single time. So I just need to heal myself somehow. So again, Warpaint helps with that. If I had something like a Morales, or Malfurion, or even Rhaegar, I would probably went for Shadow Fury or Black. Block is always good. Block is always good against like the auto attacks from Zul'jin. They're always good. I was kind of afraid to get to take block just because of the fast auto attack from Valyra, and not high damage from her. So she can just kind of burn your block charges without actually being meaningful, you know. So level 4, we did pick up the focus attack, but what you want to go for is Hurricane. If there are any slows, any major slows, like for example, let's say Earthquake is just really good. Right now in the meta, actually it was just nerfed, but if Earthquake is taken on the enemy team, you can use this to remove the entire slow for its duration. If the enemy team has, let's say, who has a root? Thrall, again, just a very, very good, because if he roots you, you activate your E and you just get out of it. It also reduces your cooldown to 3 seconds if you're whirlwind, which is obviously very, very good. The enemy team didn't have any roots, the enemy team didn't have any slows, any major slows, right? So I would just went for Focus Attack. It's always a good talent. I think this is a joke, and I think this is a joke. The splash increases the splash damage to 75% of the primary target's damage. It's a joke. It's a joke, because you just saw how minuscule that damage is, and to take a risk that somebody behind the target is going to be taking more damage, take that risk that somebody is going to be behind the target, it's pretty bad. Level 7, I did go for the newly buffed Poison Spear. Honestly, any of these is good besides, I think the Composite Spear. I've never went for Composite Spear because it just didn't seem good to me. Poison Spear is really good now because it's 150% damage increase over 6 seconds, of course, but you saw how much damage it was. It was kind of crazy how much even it took off of Varian or Valyra or anybody on their team. Follow through is another very, very good choice, but I think the best one kind of would be either Poison Spear, which I love right now, and Ferocious Healing. Ferocious Healing definitely helps you to stay alive. You will be able to use this while you're whirlwinding, and you can consume Fury to get a little bit of healing. This actually has a very low cooldown of 10 seconds. Level 10, it's really up to you. Wrath of the Berserker is perfectly fine, but I knew I had to find a way to close my gap on that Nova, and that's what I did with my Leap. Leap gives you a very, very good utility, nice stun of 1.25 seconds, kind of a better sundering, I would say, right now. Very, very good, very, very good for utility, for setting up plays, but also for getting out. You saw how much range it has. It allows you to jump out of the fight if you do desire so. Wrath of the Berserker is always going to be good for damage and for that reduction of CC against you. So it could, keep that in mind, it could be good against certain comps, for like very, very high CC comps. On 13, I did go for the Life Funnel. The normal thing here you would be either a Spell Shield or Mystical Spear. Mystical Spear, you will reduce the cooldown of your Ancient Spear and also make it always pull. So again, you can basically hit it in the air and it will just pull you to that target. So it's obviously good for like for escapes and stuff, but I feel like with the newest buffs to the healing of the E, I think the Life Funnel is much better. 35% triple against heroes is actually 105% of the damage actually done. So we're going to be healing for what right now? At level 1 for almost 450 health. For 450 health. That's a lot. That's even more than we're dealing. That's pretty crazy, boys. And that's 4 enemy hit. And if there's more than one, of course, that increases even more. That's just crazy. It kind of goes exponentially. I'm just taking way too long to explain this. It's just good. It's really good. Take it. You're not going to regret it. On 16, I did go for Nerves of Steel. I think it's still the best talent. Gives you just a little bit of that survivability you need. And also, you're able to use it while you're whirlwind. And level 20, I did go for the Crater. I do believe the Crater is good if you go for the Leap. Anger Management is meh. If you go for the Wrath of the Berserker, I definitely feel like you do need Ignore Pain, because people will just start focusing you to get you down as fast as possible. So Ignore Pain could be really good. Ignore Pain is really strong, as well as, like, in the combo with Nerves of Steel is just super strong. So you only change two talents, maybe three with the Poison Spear, but this build becomes almost a different story when you replace Sonya. I do look forward to seeing guys try this build. I want to see what results you got. Tell me down below in the comments how you did with this build. It's awesome. It's awesome. I love it. I love it. It's awesome to play Sonya again. But anyway, guys, thank you guys for watching. I hope the video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, slap that like rating and subscribe to the channel if you're new. I hope you're new. If you're new, if you're not, I love you. If you're new, I guess I love you too. I didn't make any sense. Okay, guys, I'll just see you guys in the next one.